dear learners, we are continuing our discussion on pricing. So this second part of video will take care of two learning objectives. One is, what are the factors which affect pricing? And then we shall discuss the pricing objectives and the corresponding strategies. These two learning objectives we have taken, that we shall try to understand the factors which affect pricing decisions. That in order to determine the price, in order to set the price, what are the factors which will influence the marketer? That is one thing which we shall try to understand. Then after this, we shall try to understand that what are the different pricing objectives and what will be the corresponding strategies that a marketer might adopt in order to realize the pricing objectives. These are the two aspects which we are going to discuss in this short video. The factors influencing pricing. As we have come to know, pricing is very, very important. What price to set? Is that within our hand? Or what are the different factors which influence that decision? That what price to set, how much to set, for which product? Different aspects are there. So there are a number of factors which have an influence in pricing decisions. Some factors are, as we have discussed in the part one, that the psychological aspects are there, consumers' psychological aspects. There could be some other functional, logical, cost-related aspects. The fixed cost is very high. The cost is increasing. Cost of raw materials is increasing. So cost-related factors could be there. Competition-related factors could be there, in addition to consumer psychological factors. So whatsoever, all these factors for the purpose of our convenience of understanding, we can categorize into two heads. One is external factors. The second one is internal factors. Let us try to understand what are the internal factors which influence pricing decisions. Internal factors means the factors within the organization, within the marketing organization. So the internal factors which are within the marketing organization are definitely cost. Price is basically what? Ultimately, we'll have to have sales. Sales is what? Selling price multiplied by number of units sold in the market. So that selling price, basically that sales minus cost, is the profit. So ultimately, cost is very, very important. So cost will determine price. If the cost is very high, we cannot think of searching low prices. That is plain simple as that. And this cost, as we all know, costs are different heads: fixed cost, variable cost. In terms of pricing, we'll have to see some other cost also, like say inventory cost, the cost of carrying inventory, cost of handling inventory, cost of carrying, cost of storage, cost of reordering. We'll have the production cost, direct manufacturing cost, labor cost, overhead costs. We shall have the marketing cost, discount to the retailers, discount to the wholesalers, warehousing cost, and then the different kinds of marketing cost, promotion cost, transportation cost, whether to send it through railway, road, or say inland water. So different costs are there, is that it? So all these costs will influence our pricing decision. Then, what kind of product characteristics or the features we are going to offer? If a product has got too many characteristics, suppose think about an automobile sector, an entry-level car, say Maruti Alto, will not have so many features, right? Whether it's an upgraded version, will have lots of features. So depending upon those features, the price of the product will vary. Like at the same time, at what stage of the product life cycle, my dear learners, you have already come to know about product life cycle in your product unit, that the product goes through certain stages, introduction, and then say growth, maturity, decline. So the introductory level, because the sales is not much, so cost of production is very high. But at the maturity level, cost of production will go down because of the economies of scale related benefits. So that is also a factor which will influence pricing decision. Then company goes. Suppose company wants to maximize profit. So if it wants to maximize profit, it would like to set price high. If it wants to maximize profit at a short run, it will try to earn profit at the shortest possible time. Suppose the company wants to earn development of brand building to a low price, more of advertisement like that. In that case, they might think about pricing it reasonably, right? So that it can spend more money on brand building efforts. Likewise, it could be the image sought by the firm, that our company would like to have our product to be seen by the market as a premium product. Means what? they would automatically charge a high price. At the same time, they will also give what? They will give more of product features. Then, what to what extent we would like to see our products as distinct and different from our competitors? In order to make our products distinct and different from our competitors, we will have to make investment in our research and development, innovation. We'll have to think of incorporating new features, means what? That will increase cost. And accordingly, that might result in setting a higher price also. Likewise, length of distribution. If we are interested in distributing our products across the country through the different districts, towns, cities, metropolitan areas, urban areas, rural areas, in that case, we shall have to invest heavily on our distribution infrastructure, distribution logistics. That also will help in determining the price, because in that case we might have economies of scale and we might be in a position to set our price at a low level. Likewise, the degree of promotion. If the promotion is very, very intense, like say in airlines industry, so in that case there will be cutthroat competition and will not be in a position to set a very high price. So these are some of the factors which will influence our pricing decisions. Likewise, there are another category of factors which we are clubbing as external factors, and that also influence the pricing decisions. And these are some of the things which are partially controllable, and many things are not controllable by the individual marketer, mostly the terms set by the industry. Suppose the customer demand. The customer demand, say, for the airline industry, the demand for airline industry is increasing. So definitely there will be a competition for the prices, price of the seats, air seats. Competitions, that is external to the individual marketer. Then for some products, price elasticity of demand of the product. For some products, the demand elasticity is very, very high. For some products, it may not be that high. Marketing power of the members of the marketing channel. If the distributors or the wholesalers, dealers, retailers, their own marketing power. So if they can market the product well, the price may not be that very important. See, their own sense of communication, the way the product will be advertised, those factors will be having a larger influence. That does not belittle the importance of pricing, but it takes cognizance of some other factors. Likewise, government control. Many times the price is fixed by, price is regulated by government, that you cannot charge a higher price like this, a maximum retail price, the GST. These are all fixed by government. So you cannot individually as a marketer, we cannot do anything about all those things. Buying behavior of customers, it is an external force. How would our customers buy our product? So that is not dependent on our efforts. To some extent, we can make some influence. Likewise, the income level of the customer, that is also external to the individual marketer. And then the inflation related measures, market inflation, that is also the larger macroeconomic factors. So these are set of external factors. So all these factors influence the pricing decisions. So dear learners, if you are asked that what are the factors which influence pricing decisions, basically you will have to address the question in terms of these two categories, internal factors and then external factors. Then you are supposed to understand the internal factors, the external factors, prepare a list and accordingly answer your question. Then what could the pricing objectives and what could be the corresponding strategies? In order to go for the pricing objectives, we'll have to think about some other corresponding aspects, related aspects. Like say demand determination, what could be the demand at different level of prices? Suppose our product current price is 100 rupees, if we reduce it to 180 rupees, will that increase in more demand? If we increase it say by 120, will it reduce to low demand? To what extent? Is lowering the price important, or is making the price higher is important? What would be this corresponding effect on sales? And then what would be its corresponding effect on cost? Whether cost will increase or whether cost will come down? Even if cost comes down, what kind of cost comes down? Fixed cost will come down, variable cost will go up. So we'll have to make an analysis of all these aspects. Then we shall also have to see what could be the corresponding actions by our competitors. If we reduce the price, whether our competitors are going to be silent, or whether they are also going to reduce the price. If they also reduce the price, and then they say if we keep on reducing the price, they also keep on reducing the price, what will happen? In the market, there will be cutthroat competition. So the margin will be very, very less. Select about the pricing method, which method we shall select. And then based on this, almost things, all these aspects, we'll have to select the final price. And while selecting the final price, we shall be guided by the pricing objectives. What should be our pricing objectives? Now, you will not be stated that this is your pricing objectives. You will not find an answer like that. As a learner of marketing, we can discuss about the various pricing objectives, and the individual marketer will decide which objective will satisfy their best requirements. First and foremost, each and every marketer is there in the market for survival. They will have to survive. They will have to withstand the competition. To that extent, they will have to set their price. That is, pricing should not be something that will ultimately help them, right, that they will withdraw from the market. It should not kill them. It should help them in sustaining their efforts. Survival is the best thing. Then in terms of growth, then it could be maximization of current profit. If we are concerned about maximization of current profit, so we shall go for setting high price in a short term. Or it could be the maximization of market share, that today we are not interested in maximization of current profit, but we shall help in cultivating the market, we shall help in our market development efforts, and ultimately we will be able to achieve the higher market share in the near future. So that could be, or in the long term future. So that could be a very sensible goal for a marketer. Or it could be maximization of market skimming, that the product is at the introductory stage. In our next unit, we shall discuss about this market skimming and market penetration pricing in greater details. But as of now, the marketer may be interested that it's a new product, so let us go for a very high price. Let's reap the maximum benefits from the market so that we can invest further, we can invest more on our production facilities, and we can reduce the price at a later stage. But as of now, let us go for skimming the benefit. It could be like that. Or it could be that always we shall try for improvement of our product, improvement of our quality, and we shall always set a price which will give an image that ours is a product which is basically striving for product quality literacy. So these are the various aspects by which the learners will be, my ideal learners will have to think about the pricing objectives, pricing strategies, and the factors which influence pricing. And we shall discuss the remaining part of this unit in the third video. Thank you.